if I'm honest, I think this will be the biggest test for us, because everybody expected us to beat Penang. We did the job, even though it was quite tough in the second half, but we did the job. In the end, the 3 points is what we needed. If you ask me, would you like to play well over 90 minutes and lose? I would say no. So I'm quite happy. When I woke up next day, I thought, yeah, players did good. They did the job. Against ATM, totally different. Players now, today was the first time we all came back together. We had the review of Penang, and we have preview ATM, and we realized that ATM is not a straightforward team. Changes formation very easy, from 5-3-2 to 3-5-2 to 4 to 3-4-3, and at times even to 4-4-2. So a lot of work for me in the last 2 days, but I can say I'm pleased with the way things have gone so far. The boys are looking forward to it. Confidence is good. And I think if we go by the way we've been playing the last two games, again, I look forward to a very good performance by Kelantan. Injury-wise, we seem to have everybody fit, even though we played a very tough game against Penang. I'm quite lucky in the sense that they've moved the game from a Friday to Saturday. Even though we work quite hard against Penang, I'm sure ATM run a lot more than we did at JDT, because it's really a tough place to go. I'm happy, obviously you've all seen it, that Mohamed Shawky is back. And that's why I kept saying that until he's here, I can't give you more news regarding the situation. Now he's here. He's been able to solve the family issue temporarily. It's not a long-term thing. So in Holland, we have a saying that when the bride is still at the wedding, we can't stop partying. So Shawky's back. We should just be happy and count our blessings that he's back. And he will give us more support in midfield. He will also give us support defensively. And the beauty of him being here is that I can also now push Badri more forward to be more attacking and give him more free roll with solid Shawky back, which is good news for us. So the only player really absent now is Prince Tego, but I never really had him available. Yeah, I said to you, I was disappointed that he was not back in time, but as I said, family goes forward. And he's been able to resolve it temporarily. He's looked after himself, so he'll be traveling with the team to ATM. And at some stage, I don't know whether he will start, we will see. But it's great to have him here. His leadership was missed, I think you could see in the second half against Penang, where for 25 minutes we were a bit lost. And we needed players like Mohamed Shawky. Like I said to you, after the game, my hands were very tight. I want to change, but I only have young players on the bench. So everybody keeps saying to me, yeah, but Kelantan, you know, big club, big team. But the previous managers had the luxury of picking, you know, 22 all Super League players. Now I have maybe 14 Super League, and the rest are all youth players. They need time to get to that level, which is good to have, but they're just not ready yet. So with Mohamed Shawky back, gives us an extra dimension, extra strength and depth in midfield. Oh, I think first half was not inconsistent. I think first half was quite solid, was good. Penang didn't have any chance in the first half, so I don't think that it was inconsistent. I agree with you in the second half, but that's because we analyzed it, because Penang changed the formation and my players didn't know how to adapt to the formation when Penang started throwing runners from midfield going forward. We lost Hussein also through injury, but I thought Farijam and Azim did a great job together when they moved inside. Nasri came in, did a fantastic job for us, and based on that performance, he actually deserved to start the game against ATM. So we will see. I don't think the back our defense was inconsistent against Penang. We created their chances. The goal they scored is from our throwing. So we had a bad throwing, it resulted in a goal. It's not like they've opened us up where we made mistakes. Yes, I lost Allah early on in the second half. But then after when we scored the third goal, it was okay. Again, with Shawky back, if we have a stronger midfield, it will help the back four again to be more solid and less inconsistent. Shawky can also play as a central defender. I know it's not his favourite position, but I will certainly consider that for the coming games. I don't see why not. He's here and he's a player and he's fit. So we will see what we'll do. We have two more days to prepare. Tomorrow we have a good morning session. Then we travel to ATM. We have 48 hours. So a lot can change in 48 hours. Izwan is okay. Izwan trained today. I think you saw him training. Kichi is okay. He came off out of precaution. So we want to monitor him. Sometimes if you play 2-3 games on a row, you give 110%. It's hard to maintain the level of running. It's a lot of running in this game now. So I have to try and also alternate players to keep everybody fresh in terms of fitness-wise and match fitness. So he trained today, Kachi, so he's fine. Izwan came back, Izwan trained today, he's fine. Like I said, everybody's okay. And I should have a full-strength team to travel to ATM.